Hello.
Mr. Kenny, it's Mr. T.
Mr. T, so scandalous to call me during school hours.
I'm actually calling you for something work-related, though.
Okay.
It's about that formal video.
Did you find those two students that fit my criteria?
I've been trying, but the list that you're giving me here, it's pretty long to fill. So you've said they had to be hardworking, academically superior, well-organized, great role models, prime specimens, and the list goes on. I mean,
well, surely there's two students that fit the criteria.
Well, actually, no.
I knew I couldn't trust you with such an important task.
But I do have two very eager students here, though. I'll send them over.
We good? Okay.
I'm joined here with Alice.
Hi.
Hi.
And Ben McKee.
Good morning.
I'm here with Georgia.
And I'm here with Elliot.
We're here with Tira and Lucy.
Emma, Annie and Jazz.
Molly, Emma and Alana.
Ethan and Tilly.
Joined with Callum and Caitlin today.
We're here with Pat, Zach and Andy.
Isaac, Hannah and Sienna.
Kate, Nick and Abby.
I'm joined with Tilly, Alexis, Olivia and Lily.
Ken, Jono, Benjamin and Jason.
I'm joined with Annabelle, Elise and Beth today.
Ben and Liam.
I'm joined with Elise and Ola today.
We're here with Mark and Ali, Mackenzie and Amelia. We're here with Mace and Lorcan. Guys, who was your first crush at Tintern?
Grace Jenkins. Annabelle Guskin, year 3.
Zach, but I think everyone already knew that.
Andy in year 7.
Kira Vanderbrock in year 6.
Molly Cusson in year 5.
Krishna Cannon.
Ben Winter.
I had a crush on Ola in year 9.
Pat.
Justin.
In year 7, I liked Amelia Roberts.
I'm going to have to go with Amelia Roberts.
Maddie Block.
Elise Barlow.
Reese Stevens.
Oliver Dugan.
Ollie Dugan.
Ollie in year 6.
I think it was Reese Stevens.
James Bonnyman.
Whoa! I'm going to say Noah.
Perfect, who perfect. Noah? Tristan.
You.
Max Adam in year 5.
Ben McKee in year 7.
Ned Belfinch, I think.
Jack Belfinch.
I guess you could say Chelsea.
James Manson.
Was it actually James Manson?
Sorry.
And Pat, finally, who's the lucky man that's going to be taking your mum to formal?
Elliot, I regret doing this interview.
A quick question, Ben. Are we getting a haircut for formal? And following that, are we going to be straightening our hair for formal?
No. I haven't straightened my hair in, I reckon, 3 months. So we're definitely keeping it wavy or curly. And yeah, I reckon this haircut will be suitable for the formal night. Yeah.
Who was our first kiss at Tintern?
Nick Tuliatis.
Elise.
Elise Barlow in year 10, I think.
Elise Barlow.
It was either Ulla or Elise.
Elise Dunkley, year 8 camp.
Tristan. Ben Winter.
Who was your first kiss, Elliot?
It was actually you, Georgia.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and who was your first kiss?
I think it was you.
Crazy.
Alex Curve.
Zach Rowe.
Emma Sheeran.
Grace Jenkins.
Chelsea Reagan.
Oh! Nice. Was actually okay.
Andy.
Amelia Roberts.
Nice.
Max.
Jack Belfinch.
James Manson.
You 3, I think. I kissed Noah Wright.
Oh, well, I actually haven't had my first kiss, but I was like hopeful to right now. I think we're about to find out.
What is our smoothest pickup line for formal?
They call me Dora the way my back talking.
You're a 9, but I'm the one you need.
Are you alone? Because you sure have my interest.
Are you from Tennessee? Because you're the only 10 I see.
Yeah, I just don't have one. I don't know.
Okay.
That's it.
Do you believe in love at first sight, or do you want me to walk by again? I'm not a photographer, but I can picture us together.
Did you just come out of an oven? Because you're hot.
Awesome.
If I flip a coin, what are the chances of...
Yeah, you're not allowed to say that. We can't say that.
You were charger because I'm dying without you. You were broom because you've swept me off my feet. I'm no mathematician, but I've been told I'm good with numbers. How about you give me yours so I can prove it?
Well, here I am, where I rather are two wishes.
Oh, have you got a pickup line?
No.
Alright, cool.
I don't know.
We don't have a assembly, do we?
I think we have a assembly.
I'm gonna go!
Okay, let me just ask a question.
Guys,
what are we wearing for formal night?
Well, I'm wearing a red dress.
I am wearing a pink dress.
Going with a full black suit with a green tie and pocket square.
Oh, cute. Like a light green or a dark green?
I haven't picked, but I think dark green.
Very nice.
I've got a really nice red dress, so I'm really excited to wear that.
Beautiful. And what shoes are we wearing?
We've got some black strappy heels. They're not too tall, so I'm not going to be 6'3".
Perfect. Unfortunately. And Ben, what are we wearing?
Well, I think the same as 99% of the other boys, will be wearing the same thing as last year.
I'm wearing the exact same thing from last year.
But I will get a different coloured tie, I reckon. So that's the mystery of what colour the tie will be.
Wearing a blue suit.
Black suit.
I'm probably going to be getting a nice black suit.
Suit?
Yep. What are you wearing?
Oh, I've got a light green suit and I'm going to go white shirt, no tie.
Perfect. And are we wearing any jewellery? I don't know. Is that a vibe?
No jewellery. Okay. Now can I ask you, what are you wearing?
I'm wearing also green, but a light green dress and gold jewellery.
So we're going to be like matching a little bit.
Yes, it'll be really cute.
Oh, cute.
Probably a black strapless.
I have a black dress.
A long black dress.
Black dress. I'm wearing a skirt and a corset. Color range, black, red, blue. I think one I have purple. Got a white one, except that might be a bit too...
A white dress, but like a floral pattern on it.
Ooh,
yeah.
Okay. I'm wearing like a gold brown dress.
Clothes.
I'd hope so.
I'm wearing a purple Arsena Ori set.
A dress?
Oh yeah, maybe some more description?
It's blue and it like feels like a blanket.
I think I'm going to wear a blue dress and maybe like gold jewellery as well.
Okay.
Wait,
is that actually a microphone?
Yes,
so that's why
it's actually a microphone.
So when you put this to you, that's what you're saying.
No, I've just plugged it into my phone and I'm holding it to your mouth for no reason.
So I'm joined with my new formal date. Do you want to introduce yourself, please?
Hi guys, I'm Scotty James and yeah. I'm excited to be here.
Yep.
Sorry, Scotty, I thought you were going to come to formal with me.
Yes, you just got pipped about 2 seconds ago.
But I'm pretty sure I asked first.
Yeah, no, you two are going to have to go head-to-head on this one. Or maybe why don't we just make three's a party, so.
Ooh, yeah.
We're here with Mr. Lowe, who's enjoying a nice recess. Mr. Pitcher, do you have any do's and don'ts for us on formal night? Oh, great answer. Awesome.
You know what? Actually, make sure your tie is like a good tie. Yeah? Like a really smart tie. This is like double Windsor, right? If you don't have a double Windsor right now, you've failed formal. Yeah?
What if I'm not wearing a tie?
Why would you not wear a tie? Anyway, whatever. Yep, that's my advice. You can take it or leave it.
Okay.
Do dance.
Yes.
Don't not dance.
Mr. Kenny, have you got any do's and don'ts for us on formal night?
Remember the compass. Hold the compass in your hand. Show respect for one another. Commitment towards the night integrity. We always ask, is it safe, is it kind, is it fair in the junior school? Don't be unfair to people like Elliot. That dress doesn't suit you, or where'd you get that haircut, Elliot, or those heels are too high for you.
Make sure you do have a good time.
Yep.
Okay, make sure that you don't ever get to a point where you don't remember it.
Make sure you stay sober so you can actually enjoy the night. Don't feel pressured to ask someone to go with you just because sometimes it's better to just hang out with your mates.
I think fulfillment at the end of the night, reflect upon everything that's gone on, and just hopefully you've had a good night. Compassion for those who perhaps are sitting on their own and have got no one. Myself, I never danced with anybody at the formal, I wasn't asked.
I think the big do, you just have a great time. The don'ts, if you're ordering a dress online, make sure you check that it fits.
Yes.
Because we don't want to have any, it has to pass the Mrs. Ruckett test of standard.
Obviously don't wear heels that are too big for you. Make sure you get out on the dance floor. Hit the dance floor as much as possible.
Confidence to ask other people. Take responsibility.
Okay, great.
Deuce, dance. Lots of dancing. Socialising. Yeah, it's obviously the formal. It's the formal, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Don't show up late.
Yeah.
Be on time. That's a do. And that's all I've got for you, so...
Welcome to an Elite Odds update brought to you by BradBet. Now tonight is the big one, the Tintern Formal. So we've got some healthy odds for you to jump on, as well as a special multi for you. The first market I want to show you is the first heels off. We've got three reasonable options for you. Alice Callahan coming in at $1.35. We've got Hannah Desmond at $1.60 and Molly Carson at $1.65. And the next market I want to show you is the most likely to show up late. We've got Beth Noddle coming in. Based on recent form, she's the favourite at $1.30. We've got Georgia Norton a bit further out at $1.90. And sorry, we've got Brinton Mahadeva. Late movement from Brinton here. He's now the favourite at $1.10. Incredible stuff there. Now the last market I want to show you is the rowdiest on the dance floor. We've got Zach Crowe starting at $1.20 and some late movement here from Mark Evans to bring him out to $1.30. Based on last year's form, that is some impressive movement. Now the last one is a bit of an outsider, Elise Barlow at $2.25. Now finally, I'll pack it all into a same formal multi for you. I'm going to take Hannah Desmond for first heels off. We're going to go for Beth Noddle to be latest arrival. And based on last year's form, I want Mark Evans to be rowdiest on the dance floor. Fingers crossed we get another worm tonight. Now all of that comes out to a cheeky $4.50, and that's free money if you ask me. Jump on board and gamble responsibly.
What it?
Shut up! Mace, stay, bro! What are you doing? Who's gonna be best dressed at formal?
Abby
Winter?
Abby.
Probably Abby.
I think Abby.
I'm gonna say Abby.
I think Abby.
Abby or Alice?
Alice?
My bet's on Alice.
I'm with Alice.
I think Ethan's gonna be best dressed.
I think Keely, actually.
Nick.
Kate
Ensor.
Okay, Mark, have you got an answer?
Oh,
off.
Me. Just watch.
Maybe Mace, honestly.
I'm going to say Mace.
Mace, because he has the money to buy a nice suit.
Angel was best dressed girl last year, so she might bring it again.
Lucy.
I'm looking forward to his.
Zach Muhammad will have a very nice suit. He is a very...
No, he's super nice.
Fresh male.
You.
Maybe Emma Dodds.
Georgia.
I think you, Georgia.
Oh, okay.
Jonathan, yes.
Well, I'll say Ken.
I'm gonna say Molly Cousin.
Molly.
Molly, I don't know what people are wearing. I know there's a group chat, but yeah. Molly. Elliot,
cool. Maybe you.
I'd say probably Elliot.
I'll have to go with you there, mate. You've got a pretty good suit style.
Thanks, man. That's really cute. I like that. Thanks.
What is probably the worst thing to say to a date on formal? I know you never got a date, but what?
Oh! Are you sure you want to go out with me?
You know what? You know what? Just don't show up with another date. I mean, I've already committed over here, so don't show up with intentions elsewhere. Be committed, you know.
Is that what you're really wearing?
Are you really wearing that?
You're not going to go out looking like that.
Did you really pay for that makeup?
You look fat.
Who do you think is going to be rowdiest at the after party?
Probably Nick.
Kate.
I'm going to say Kate.
Kate?
Okay. I'm
going to
say Kate as well.
Say it.
Mark. Mark Evans will be pretty rowdy.
Andy.
Andy Durham.
Andrew Durham.
Georgia.
I'm gonna say you, Georgia.
Me, okay. Yeah.
Molly.
Oh.
I feel like Molly or something.
Either Molly or Amelia.
Amelia
and
Drew.
Amelia.
Amelia.
Mackenzie for sure.
Hi.
You. You, Elliot.
Aw.
Pat Reed.
Probably like Zach Crowe, to be honest.
Lorcan McRae.
I think Beth will be.
Emma Sheeran.
Emma.
I wanna say Emma Sheeran.
I don't know, Tristan.
I have to say Tristan.
Tristan.
I'll go with Tristan.
Yeah, Tristan, okay.
So.
What do you think?
I thought it was shambolic, moronic, idiotic. It was probably the worst formal video I've ever seen. It was immature. It was everything that the compass isn't. It lacked humor, it lacked creativity, it lacked togetherness, it was just embarrassing. It was an absolute shamble. Get out of here and take the video with you and don't come back.
You still want to post it, right?
Oh yeah, absolutely.